guys, Brandon Pope with Georgia Wildlife Solutions here with you today. And today we're going to be doing a video on how to remove beaver castors. The castor glands are located right here on a beaver, right on either side of the vent. And the castor itself is used in all types of stuff, from making perfumes to vanilla extract to making other lures for trapping. So it does add another layer of income if you can get in on harvesting those glands when you harvest your beaver. So you're going to go a couple of inches above the vent. And this is if you're not skinning out your beaver. If you skin out your beaver, you can just go ahead and skin it, and you can remove those glands when you get down to this area. But this is if you're not going to be, for whatever reason, skinning out your beaver. So you just make an incision just a couple of inches above the vent. And you're going to want to start to pull back a little bit. There's a fatty layer here. If you cut through that fatty layer, you'll see the castor glands. They're kind of a silverish color. Silver and blue. And if you puncture those, now you want to try not to puncture them. Sometimes it happens, and if it happens, it's okay. But there are different grades of castor. If you get a full sack that's not punctured in any way and it's dried correctly, then you can get more money for it. But you can start to see the glands right here. And you just have to start to pull those away from the body. See, I've broken through that little membrane there. And they'll start to come out easier now. During the springtime, these will be full of castor. During this time of the year, we're in winter here in Georgia, there's not as much castor there. However, there's still some, and you can see it starting to come out back there at the vent. Take and pull that back. There's also right here some oil sacs that some people, especially people that make lure, find valuable. If you can get those out as well, you're going to start to pull back, pull back, pull back, and it begins to, you can see there are the castors. Now these two sacks will be full a little later in the year, but it doesn't hurt to go ahead and save these as well. And that's all beaver castor right there, kind of liquidy today. You take those, and there's the opening there. You take and flip that, you can hang those and let them dry, or you can put them in a bag and freeze them. And that's how you remove beaver castor. Wishing y'all a good day, and God bless.